Hey guys, welcome back to G-Made CNC. Today's a real quick one. As you can see, my computer's sitting on an end stand or something I had kicking around the shop here. Just received the computer arm. Came in that box there. It was on back order for about 2 weeks. But Tormach was great. Got emails and updates reassuring me when it was coming and stuff. So as far as all that, they were very helpful. So let's get started and get this opened. The manual here. Yeah. A check sheet. And it's very simple. Screws. And I think that's it. Let's see. Well, there's the top. Yeah, that's about it. All right, let's get this installed. Let's take a look at the instructions. All right, what I noticed from page 1, 2, 3, and 4, they're the same instructions that came with the mill for their arm. It's just the last page they show you. You do not have to drill the front of it. They come with pre-drilled holes, which are mounted on the very side of the unit. Which you can see there. There's your holes. The other fourth hole is behind the door. Let's get that out of the way. So as far as assembly, you could follow the instructions from the arm on. You do not have to drill holes in the front of the lower base, as the first four pages describe. They're for the Tormach mill if you have one. So let's get started. You're gonna need 4 6-millimeter cap screws and a 6-millimeter Allen key wrench. Make sure these slots are facing towards the back. This is where your wires will run through. And they'll come out here to go up the pole. Next, we'll be installing the main post. It's as simple as just sliding it in here and tighten it up to your desired height. Once you guys get that in, snug it up to a reasonable height so it doesn't slide down on you. That can all be adjusted after everything's in place. Next, I noticed on my particular one, these are backwards. This is for the monitor, this is for the table. So it's just as simple as flipping it around. Next, let's get some better camera view. just snug these down just so you have an area to work without it flopping around on you. That'll work for now. This is a 8mm Allen key and a 16mm wrench. Next, you'll need 4 4mm cap screws, lock washers, and a regular washer to mount the table. Now, the table comes with 4 screws mounted on the bottom here. That has to face downward. It's for the e-stop button. So this will get, this is upside down. Let's just flip that. Four millimeter Allen key. Now as you tighten these, just snug them up at first. And once they're all snug, then give it a little twist afterwards. You don't want to over tighten them because they will suck up right into the wood. So now that's in. Let's get the monitor on. Now the monitor I'm using, it's just an LG 17-inch monitor. I have to go with this, just a little bit larger, around the same price as Tormach 15-inch, but I preferred the bigger monitor. Now the kit does not come with any hardware for mounting the monitor, so you got to dig around through an old screw bin or something. All right, so come to find out, my alignment holes are too narrow for the plate that it comes with. So yeah, I'm gonna just take that off right now and drill new holes to mount up to my monitor, and we'll get back to the installation. I'll be right back, guys. Okay, now that we got that all drilled out, these are the holes from Tormach. These are the holes I needed. So let's just get this mounted up. Now we'll grab our monitor and our hardware and get the monitor mounted. Now that the monitor's mounted, we can proceed to put these clips and the zip ties on the pipe, like so. These will have to be mounted and screwed into the pipe here. Just like so. There's 3 of them. Now after these are screwed in, I'm gonna have to spin this around towards the backside. So the wires, when they come out of here, will run up the backside of the pipe. So let's get this spun around so the holes are facing towards the back. This would be a good time to adjust your height, depending on how tall you are for your keyboard and monitor. So now we got the holes in the back here. We'll proceed to install the wire guides with the gold fine thread screws. I'll just slide the zip tie right in here, which we'll need afterwards when we run our wires. So once you get all your clips in and your zip ties, we can start running all our cables from the hole here up through the channel. It'll be out of here, up the back side of this, then we'll zip tie them and proceed to hook up the monitor, keyboard, mouse, and jog wheel. So let me get that going and we'll be right back. After snaking all your wires from your computer, your extension wires, your e-stop, which I had to take apart. I didn't want it just dangling around. I liked it to go through here too. So there's only two screws and a nut for the end. It's fairly simple. So after chasing them through, making sure that they were long enough to make it up to the back, I also marked them so you don't get confused and having to go back and forth. Now we can hook up the monitor, mouse, jog wheel, and keyboard and fasten them down. So we'll get that together right now. Now that we got all the wires run, I haven't zip tied them yet. What I also did was just put some electrical tape and the USB ports, so there's no chance of them pulling apart inside this metal channel as we pull it back through. And then we'll proceed to reinstall the wire into the e-stop and get that mounted. So let's get this all tucked away and cleaned up. Now that we got the wires all tucked away neatly, and zip tied, I just wrapped some electrical tape around it, keep it nice and tight and neat. Also wrapped this with electrical tape, just to prevent any wearing, you know, against the metal rail there. Same for here. You also want to make sure that the stand is pushed out all the way before you tighten everything down, seeing that it'll pull and cause rubbing against here. Swings beautifully. The other thing was, no biggie, but two of these screws lined up with the holes that were pre-drilled. The other two you just have to manually screw in yourself. So let's get this thing turned on. Make sure everything is hooked up correctly. Mouse is good. Keyboard's good. Jogging wheel is good. Thank you. That's a beautiful thing right there. Now for one last thing to finish this job up. Little trusty Toramach sticker. No job's complete. It's a beautiful thing right there. Well, this is just a quick one. Appreciate you guys watching. If there's anything I left out or you have any questions about, please comment below. Take care, guys.